Hello and welcome to another episode of PingCasts. Today we are going to be modifying Conky. I'm going to show you how to modify Conky. We will be editing the configuration file directly, but it's not that bad. So first of all, we're going to open up our web browser. We're going to search for Conky. We'll go to Conky Home, conky.sourceforge.net. This is their website. We'll go to their documentation page. Variables, config files, and Lua API are what you're going to want to worry about. I haven't really touched Lua API much, but this can help you do stuff like bend your bars or do other fancy stuff if you want sort of elliptical stuff going on. It allows you to, I guess you're not fixed to like a block of, if I had a gauge or something, it wouldn't be a block straight left or right. I could try to make it sort of a, like a circle or something like that. It allows you to manipulate the Conky a bit more, but I mean, you don't have to mess with the Lua API. Configuration. This will control Conky, like, is it on the right, is it going to be on the left, is it going to be in the middle, top, bottom, whatever. This is pretty much your, sort of like your configuration settings. You could set things like default colors for text, so if the text color isn't specified, it'll be that default color. Give that a read. Conky objects, now this is what you're actually going to see with the text. And, well, let's just open up Nautilus. We'll press Control H to show our hidden files. .conkyrc. Double click this. And then click on display contents. Oops. Alright. So this is my Conky. As you can see, okay, here are variables. This is our objects, our Conky objects. As you can see, we have a dollar sign, and then an open curly brace, and then a closed curly brace. That's how you use your objects. It goes inside a dollar sign, and then two braces. So here's each object. This controls the text to get the offset. We have an image here. That's the pin guy symbol. Here this shows which kernel it is, dollar and kernel inside of curly braces. This is a type of divider. See, we're controlling our font here, CPU 1, but see, when it shows the CPU, it starts counting from 0. CPU 0 is the first CPU, but this is just so we see CPU 1, you see CPU 1, but the computer thinks CPU 0 is the first CPU. Alright. So here we have 2 and 3 for additional cores. See, I actually have a quad-core processor, so I'm going to go ahead and uncomment these. Save. And it should restart. If it doesn't, we can just kill it. Kill all Conky. Conky. And see here? Now we have 4 cores. All 4 of my cores are showing up. So let's see here. Oh, I just saw something. Desktop. Desktop number desktops. So let's add something to Conky. We'll say number of desktops, one, and then $2 curly braces, and inside here, we're just going to put in desktop. Save that. And number of desktops, one. I think if you're using Vim, then it should restart. Let me see here. But that's a bit more of an advanced text editor. You might want to stick to gedit. Which is what we use to open it. But I'm just going to stick with Vim here because it's auto-starting, or auto-restarting Conky whenever I save a change. But again, to open Conky, we go to our home folder, press Control H to show hidden files. Here's .conkyrc. Well, we can double-click, then click on Display, and here it is. Press Control H to hide the files again. And what else can we do? Desktop name. How about desktop number? I'll say desktop number. And inside of curly braces, I'm going to have desktop underscore number. Write the change. Okay. Let me try and escape that, because it might, yep, it thinks it's a comment. But I'm commenting it out. I am not commenting it out. Be careful if you're going to be using symbols like that. The backslash is an escape character. It's basically a hashtag in the file says I want to comment this out. This is just a comment. Do not read it as code. A backslash is an escape character. It's saying I don't want this read as code. This is literally a hashtag. Do not read it as anything else. It's just what it is. Alright. So. Let's do something. Wireless link qual PERC, but which interface? My first wireless card is what I'm using for next, and it's in WLAN 0. Done. It's going to display the number, but I'm just going to put a percent sign here so we see a percent sign. Write the change. Here we have 71%. Let's take that percent sign away. It's just a number. Say percent. Say wireless quality, and then we have wireless quality 71%. You can do quite a bit with Conky. You could have to give you your 5-day forecast. I think there's something there to check your EVE Online. Something with EVE Online. I don't really remember what it is. I haven't played that before. But you can do so much with Conky. I mean, the sky just seems to be the limit with Conky. cool. PingCasts is set up so you can alt-click and drag. Just don't minimize, otherwise Conky will be included. Other than that desktop button shell extension I showed in one of my videos, that seems to not minimize Conky. But everything else probably will. Let's do some more. Time zone. So we could say time is TV time, and I think in the format we'll say America/New York, and hopefully that's how it's supposed to be. Yep. 27th of January, 6:32. You've seen my vertical Conky in my open box. Let's make that right now. I will make that right now. That'll be an awesome thing. Let me do this graphically for you. Let me go to home. I will create a new document. We'll make it. Oops. I will make an empty document. We'll call this Conky RC, and I'll put -openbox because this is the way it's an open box. It was a vertical Conky. Actually, I'm not rewriting the entire thing from scratch. Let me use a template. I will go to the top of the hierarchy. Where is ETC? Go in here. Conky. Copy conky.conf. Go home. Paste it here. Rename it. Conky RC-openbox. I'll just clear out all this text. And now, let's do this. What did I do? That's what I did. I think CPU will just monitor them. I'm doing this from memory. I'll say CPU graph, CPU 0. Now make the graph monitor all your CPU cores at once. We'll have white, no black, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is in hex. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 will be black and white. We'll say memory. Mem graph 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then what else here? Internet. I'll say wireless link. Percent WLAN 0, the percent sign. I'll say our up speed graph. Oh, I forgot something here. We thing. It specified the size of the graph. We'll do 10 by 75 here. 10 by 75. And the upspeed graph will also be 10 by 75. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Downspeed will be downspeed graph. 10 by 75. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We'll say temperature. I'm typing sensors-f. Want my CPU temperature, type that into graph. CPU temperature. Alright, I want the second column. Awk. Print by 2. Oops. I want the third column. I don't want that plus sign. Said. And we'll say switch the plus sign with nothing. We have 131 degrees Fahrenheit. So, exact I will execute command at an interval of every 60 seconds. Sensors-f, type ref, CPU temperature, type awk, print $3, type sed, and we'll switch the plus with nothing. Save that, say no gap there, alignment, say top middle, okay, then maybe conky-c for an alternate config file, conky-rc-openbox, and here we go. Maybe we can give it a bit of a gap. 5, how about 10? Go. Give 50 to get it clear of the bar. Now. Oh, it seems to have crashed. Okay, here we go. Here we are. There's a conky. It's flickering, so let's do double buffer. Does it change? And we're flickering. I don't want a background. Own window transparent. Yes. Forgot, let me look at the other pin guy conky. We will to make it alt click and drag, because you can't actually drag it. You have to put something in there. It makes it a window without decorations and all this other stuff. Look in the conky file. Own window hints undecorate below sticky skip taskbar skip pager. Let's paste that into here. And own window class. We'll say normal. Save it. My CPU and it's monitoring the CPU in its entirety, not any single core. This is my RAM usage, my internet. I think I made a mistake on upspeed graph. Yep, I did not specify which interface to use. UWM0. Actually, I'm not sure where it goes. Let me put it before the numbers. WM0. Save that. Let's restart it. And there we go. CPU in its entirety, RAM, internet quality, upspeed, downspeed, and my temperature, which updates at every 60 seconds. I'm doing it at an interval, so that way it's not a continuing command constantly. Otherwise, because that would drain system resources. And, yeah. That's about what I use for OpenBox. And then I would set a margin in OpenBox so that, and I put it up at the top, and then I would always be able to see it. So that's how you modify your Conky file. Thanks for watching this episode, and stay tuned for another one.